Hello friends, I'm Dr. Vijay Prakash and today I'll be talking to you about retention in complete dentures. Now what is retention? Retention by definition is that quality inherited in the dental processes which acts to resist the force of dislodgement along the path of placement. Or we can say retention is resistance to displacing force which acts on the denture tending to cause a movement towards the occlusal surface. So retention basically resists in displacing the force away from the tissue surface. So that inherent property of the processes to resist vertical dislodging forces is known as retention. What are goals for achieving retention? Now according to S. Friedman in 1957, he advocated there are three basic goals for achieving retention in complete dentures. One is maximal coverage without undue displacement of the tissues. Second is development of good border seal. And third is adequate provision for resistance area. So these are the goals when you want to achieve retention in complete dentures. Also in 1948, Sir Wilfrid Fridge gave three principal factors that affect the retention of complete dentures. Now, those three factors, according to him, were denture-bearing surface, a good balanced harmonious occlusion, and third, a properly formed polished surface. And if we see the classification of retention of complete dentures based on the factors which affect retention, you have principally five factors which affect retention of complete dentures. Now, what are those five factors? They are anatomic factors, mechanical factors, physical factors, psychological factors, and surgical factors. Now, let us see each of these one by one. Biological factors first. Biological factors can be of three types. One are the anatomical factors, they can be physiological factors, and they can be muscular factors. First, the anatomical factors. And in anatomical factors, you have basically the size of denture bearing areas. So greater the size of denture bearing area, greater will be the amount of retention in complete dentures. We all know that the maxillary arch have a greater denture bearing areas, which is approximately 22.96 centimeter square. Whereas if you see compare it with a lower denture, which is only 12.25 centimeters square. So definitely maxillary dentures have more retention than the mandibular dentures. That is, this is because of the size of the denture bearing areas. Next anatomic factor is quality of denture bearing areas. Of course, if you have a firm keratinized tissues, they will provide very good support and they will not move easily. And therefore, they will provide maximum retention in comparison to tissues which get easily displaced during function. Like if you have these tissues here, which are mobile or hyperplastic over this, then definitely the retention of the complete denture will be very poor in comparison if you have a firm, you have more firm and keratinized tissues. Also, if whenever we are doing arrangement, we should see that the teeth should be placed over the non-compressible tissues and also away from a severely inclined plane. Basically, you should avoid an inclined plane. So, if we see a lower arch, the incisors, canines and the premolars, that is these teeth, should be directly placed over the crest of the ridge. And these molars, as we come towards the molar teeth, these molar teeth should be placed lateral to the mylohyoid ridge, that is over a hard buccal bony plate where you have the primary stress bearing area, that is the buccal shelf region. So the molar, if you see, the molar should be placed here. This will be the best area in which it will be able to bear the functional forces better. Whereas in the upper arch, if we see that the teeth are placed slightly anterior, if you see they are placed slightly anterior to the crest of the ridge in order to provide a a good retention and in order to provide a good aesthetics to the complete dentures. And that is the reason slight anterior to the crest of the ridge, you should place the maxillary teeth in the upper arch. Next type of biological factors are the physiological factors. In this, first is the quantity and quality of saliva. Now, definitely the quality of the saliva determines the retention. Now, if the saliva in between the denture base and the tissues, if it is thick and ropey, then definitely it will accumulate between the tissue surface of the denture and the mucosa, which will lead to loss of retention. Apart from this, if we have thin and watery saliva, that will also have a reduced retention because it will be too thin to provide adhesion or cohesion. That is the physical factors, which we'll be talking about slightly later in this part of discussion. So definitely the quality of the saliva should be a mixed type in which it should not be either too thick or it should not be too watery in order to achieve a good retention in complete dentures. Next type of physiological factor is the condition of mucosa and submucosa. Here we should keep in mind that there should be maximum coverage without undue displacement of the tissues when we are making impressions. Because if you have maximal coverage of the denture bearing areas, you will have a better retention because maximal coverage will give you a good retention of complete dentures. Next type of physiological factor is the neuromuscular control. Neuromuscular control basically refers to functional forces which are exerted by the musculature of the patient that can affect retention definitely. And it is also a learned biological phenomena. So definitely you have to educate the patient. You have to initially tell whenever the patient is getting a new denture, you have to tell the patient that you have to adapt to the new processes. And it is the individual's ability to learn and adapt with a good neuromuscular control. That is basically a good motor coordination and coordinated reflexes, which will help the patient to have patient to basically adapt to the processes better in comparison to patients who are not having a good neuromuscular control. So this plays a very important role in retention of complete dentures. You may have seen a patient who can come to your clinical practice with a broken denture and still he is able to function with the broken processes. So that means that the patient is having a very good neuromuscular control. Apart from this, you have ridge characteristics. Now, an ideal ridge which is parallel or nearly parallel with adequate vertical height, like if you see, this is an ideal cast where you have adequate vertical height and the ridges are parallel to each other and you have a more flatter crest of residual alveolar ridge. So in this type of ridge, you will have maximum amount of support, you will have a good stability and you will have a good retention of the complete dentures. Next type of physiological factors are ridge relationship. Now, definitely you should have a good interarch space between the upper and the lower ridges, because if you have excess of interarch distance, that will result in poor stability and retention because of increased leverage. So if you have this excess of space between the height, the crest of the ridge and the teeth, then it will have poor leverage. The chances of displacement of this will be very high. The denture will be unstable and also it will not have good retention of complete dentures. So you should have a good interarch space. Also, if you have very less interarch space, so you will hardly have space for placing the teeth, and that will also interfere or encroach into the freeway space, and that will lead to basically poor retention in complete dentures, and also there will be discomfort to the patient. Next, you have the muscular forces. Now, there are a number of muscles which are basically acting in the region of the oral cavity where they can affect the retention and stability of the complete dentures. So these are all the muscles which you see in front of you. And these orofacial muscles basically provide a supplementary type of retentive force. And if you see that the teeth should be arranged always in a neutral zone between the cheek and the tongue. So what is a neutral zone? It is basically a potential space between the lips and cheeks on one side and the tongue on the other side. So that is basically to have a balance of forces, a balance of muscular forces, so that there is no displacive action because of these muscles on the dentures, stability and retention. Another thing is the polished surface of the dentures should be properly shaped. This is very important, because if you are not having the polished surface, is say you have overextension here, then it interferes at the origin and insertion of these muscles, and these muscles fibers are going to displace this dentures, and there will be loss of retention and stability of the processes. So So the denture border, that is the denture border part of the polished surface, should be relieved wherever you have these muscle fibers, especially in the region of the buccal frenum or labial frenum. In those areas, the denture should be relieved. Like this, you have this area where you have the buccal frenum which comes in, and you have the labial frenum. So you should definitely relieve this region. You should provide adequate space for the function of the muscles, so that the muscles do not displace the dentures, and it results in poor retention of the complete denture processes. So the correct development of the polished surface depends on the correct peripheral thickness as well as correct tooth position. So both these factors are very important in helping in getting good retention of the complete denture processes. Now, if we see the polished surface of the upper denture. Now, in the upper denture, the buccal surface should face downwards and outwards. If you see this flange, the polished surface, they should place downwards and outwards. And likewise, the palatal surface should place downwards and inwards. That is, towards the inner side of the palatal surface in the denture. And why do we do this? This is to get the net result is to get resultant retaining vertical force, which will act on the upper denture, and it will help in seating the complete dentures into position. So basically, it will help in having a good retention in complete dentures. So if you see, this matters when you are doing the wax trial or wax up of the dentures. You should be very careful, because if you have thickness here, this will displace the processes, because they will interfere in the functioning of the muscles, and those muscles are going to displace your processes, and your process is going to lose retention. Similarly, if you see in the lower denture, the buccal surface slopes upwards and outwards, and the lingual surface slopes upwards and inwards. Again, this is to ensure downward retaining force on the lower denture, because this downward force is going to help in seating of the complete dentures, and also will help in having a good retention of the complete denture processes. And as a result of this, because of this, you will also have adequate space for the tongue to function. And because tongue is very important muscle organ, which also helps in providing you a good retention. The base of the tongue, if you see, it provides the emergency retentive force. That is, in case of emergency, if this denture tends to lift upwards, this tongue muscle is going to push the denture downwards in order to seat this. So this acts as an emergency retentive force and helps in retaining the dentures better. And this is all possible if you have given adequate space for the tongue to function. Apart from this, your occlusal plane should be at the correct level. If you have the occlusal plane which is going downwards or upwards, again, it will contribute to instability in the dentures and also loss of retention. And the denture bases should be extended over to the maximum area possible, as I have told you before also. And also the muscle control and patient tolerance is a very plays a very important role in retention of complete dentures processes, because it is the muscle control, as I told you before also, the neuromuscular control is that the patient, it enables the patient to function with dentures which rest on the slippery base, which you can see the dentures are basically plastics which are placed on a slippery base, and they are supposed to function as your natural teeth, not like natural teeth, because they are supposed to function. So you are basically making a plastic function in the patient's mouth and doing all the functions which a normal natural teeth does. So muscle control and patient tolerance also plays a very important role in retention of complete dentures. So apart from these are all the biological factors which we have just spoken about, then we have the mechanical factors. Under mechanical factors, first we have the undercut. Under mechanical factors, you have undercuts. Now in undercuts, if we are having mild undercuts, they will help in retention of the dentures. And if we have unilateral undercuts, you can take help of those undercuts, and that will be helpful in increasing the retention of the complete dentures. That is how we can do that. So if we have a unilateral undercut, as you can see in the figure, you can modify the path of insertion of the dentures, and you can take the help of this undercut, which will aid in retention of the complete dentures, provided on the other side you don't have a severe undercut, or you don't have an undercut, so that the processes will be able to smoothly go in. But what if you have a severe bilateral undercut, as you can see in this figure? Now, if you have a severe bilateral undercut, this undercut will not allow the complete denture to be completely seated without injuring the tissues. So the overlying mucosa will be injured when you are going to place the processes, or when you are going to attempt to remove the processes. So definitely it will not be possible for a patient to function with such type of processes. So in such cases, if you have a severe bilateral undercuts, you should go for a pre-prosthetic surgery, at least on one side or on both the sides, whatever the case may be, accordingly, and make sure that you don't have severe undercuts, because mild undercuts will aid in retention of the complete dentures. But when you have severe bony undercuts, then you have to go for a pre-prosthetic surgery. Next factor is the retentive springs. Now these are also the mode of retention, but they are not currently used in retention of complete dentures. The retention springs are given in this region, and they are supposed to aid in retention of dentures. But mostly what we have seen why they are not used is they contribute to instability of the dentures, and that is the reason they also happen to reduce the amount of stability in a complete denture, and that is the reason they are not currently used in practice. Next mechanical factors are magnets. Now these are intramucosal magnets which help in improving the retention of highly resorbed ridges. So below the periosteum, you'll be placing these intramucosal magnets, and they'll be aiding in retention of the processes. And these magnets can be rare earth metals like iron, samarium cobalt, or they can be samarium cobalt, which is very commonly used. And the advantages are they improve the retention very much. And they increase patient satisfaction and security, because they have increased amount of retention of complete dentures. The marginal integrity is maintained, which allows for fabrication. There is extended longevity of the processes. But the drawback here is there is low corrosion resistance, there is increased cost, cytotoxic effect, and there are chances of wearing of the magnets. Once the magnets wear, then again you have to repeat the process, and that becomes traumatic for the patient. Next mechanical factor is denture adhesives. And denture adhesives are non-toxic soluble materials. which can be supplied in the form of, say, powder, cream, or a liquid. And these are applied on the tissue surface of the denture. So these denture adhesives applied on the tissue surface of the processes, they can be sprinkled in if they are in the form of powder. As you can see in the figure, this is an denture adhesive powder. Or if they are supplied in the form of tube, they can be applied on the tissue surface of the denture in the form of tube. And this, once it is applied evenly, then it is placed into the patient's mouth. The patient is asked to bite on these processes. They are instructed to hold on for a few minutes, and then the patient is able to do all the functions, and definitely it improves the retention of the processes. Next mechanical factors is suction chambers. This is a very, very old concept, and it was used in the past to aid in retention of the maxillary denture, because in the upper denture, people used to provide a kind of a suction tip which is going to build up negative pressure, and it was going to improve the retention of the maxillary dentures. But the problem with using such type of suction chambers was, because of the negative pressure, they had a potential to create palatal hyperplasia, and in some extreme cases even it was palatal perforation in the palate. So definitely this type of suction chamber should never be used to aid in retention of complete dentures in relation to complete dentures, because that is detrimental to the overall health of the tissues in the palatal region, and that is the reason they should not be used. Next factor is contour of the denture base. This factor I already explained when I explained to you about the muscular factors. According to this, the polished surface of the denture base should be properly placed, and there should be proper contouring and designing of the polished surface, because they should harmonize with the function of the tongue, lips and cheeks, and this all enables proper seating of the dentures. That is what I told you when I was talking in the muscular factors also. Next factors are the parallel buccal and lingual walls. Now, these provide significant retention by increasing the surface area between the denture base and the mucosa, and this increases the retention by increasing the interfacial surface tension and also the atmospheric pressure. So, if you have a parallel buccal and lingual walls, then definitely it improves the retention. These walls, if they are parallel to each other, they increase the surface area and they aid in retention of the complete denture processes. Apart from this, other type of mechanical factor is reduced buccolingual width of the teeth. Now, if you see the teeth, the buccolingual width of the teeth of a denture is much less than what you see in a natural tooth. This is to reduce the displacive force and increase the retention. How that happens? Like, if you have a reduced buccolingual width of the teeth, there will be less volume of food which the patient will be able to chew at a time. And because of this, there will be less muscular forces. Less muscular forces means less displacive forces on the dentures, and less displacive forces means increased retention of the processes. Next factors are physical factors. Now, under physical factors, you have adhesion. What is adhesion? Adhesion is, by definition, the physical attraction of unlike molecules to one another. So, adhesion of saliva to the mucous membrane and the denture base is achieved through ionic forces between charged salivary glycoproteins and surface epithelium or acrylic resin. So, you have this saliva which you see with the blue color mark, that is between the denture base and the tissues. So these glycoproteins which are there on the saliva, they are going to contact with the surface of the denture base and contact with the surface of the tissues. So these are unlike molecules which have a physical attraction with each other through ionic forces, and a thin film of saliva formed between the denture and the tissue surface helps to hold the denture to the mucosa, and thereby aiding in retention of the complete denture processes. So retention by adhesion is supposed to be directly proportional to the amount of denture bearing area. So definitely we should always record the tissues so that we have a broad surface area, and the denture base, the surface area is increased, because increased surface area will have a better retention. Next physical factor is cohesion. It is the physical attraction of like molecules to each other. This occurs between the molecules of the saliva. So if you have a watery serous saliva, they form a thinner film, and it is supposed to be more cohesive than a thick mucous saliva. As you told in the beginning also about the quality of the saliva, you should have a normal consistency which should not neither be too thick or too thin. And here, because of this, the quality of the saliva, the cohesion plays a big role in retention of the complete dentures. Next type of physical factor is the interfacial surface tension. It is the resistance to separation of two parallel surfaces that is imparted by the film of saliva between them, and the thin film of saliva tends to resist the displacive forces which tends to separate the denture from the tissues. So if you would have seen a very simple experiment, that if you have two glass plates and if you take a thin film of water between them, then it is very difficult to separate them if you are trying to separate them with a vertical force, because until unless you don't slide them, it will not be possible for you to remove it. So it is the same factor which plays a role in the retention of complete denture, that is the interfacial surface tension. The next factor is atmospheric pressure. The atmospheric pressure helps to resist the dislodging forces applied to the dentures, provided the dentures have a good peripheral seal. So if your border molding is good, your final impression is good, and you have a good peripheral seal of your processes, then this particular factor plays a very important role in the retention of complete dentures. So this peripheral seal will prevent the entry of air between the denture surface and the soft tissues, and when displacing forces act on the denture, partial vacuum is produced between the denture and the soft tissues, which helps in holding the denture and which helps in retaining the processes in place. And retention due to atmospheric pressure is directly proportional to the area covered by the denture base, and atmospheric pressure is also referred to as emergency retentive force or temporary restraining force. Atmospheric pressure also plays an important role in trapdoor mechanism. Now, what is trapdoor mechanism? Whenever there will be instability in the denture, say any lateral force on the denture, and the denture will have a tendency to move away from the denture base, then what is going to happen? There will be partial vacuum, as I just mentioned, and because of the atmospheric pressure, it is going to uplift the denture upwards so that it does not fall, and this is known as the trapdoor mechanism. Next physical factor is the capillary action. Capillarity action is there when there is a close adaptation between the denture and the mucosa, and a thin film of saliva tends to flow and increase its surface contact, thereby increasing the retention. Especially in this region, if you see, you have a thin film of saliva, you have the denture base, and you have these tissues, and this thin film of saliva will contribute to retention of the processes. Next physical factor is gravity. So when a person is in an upright position, gravity will act as a retentive force for the mandibular denture, and any displacive force for the maxillary denture. So gravity will try to make the maxillary denture unstable by applying a displacive force, but it is going to have a seating effect on the lower denture because of this gravitational force which will aid in retention of the complete denture processes. Under psychological factors, you have intelligence to keep the denture in place. Secondly, you have expectation. This is very important because you have to educate the patient right from the beginning of the treatment, right from when you are taking history of the patient, about and you have to give realistic expectation to the patient. The patient should have realistic expectation regarding the denture treatment. The patient should not have unrealistic expectation about your treatment, because at the end of the day, as I told you before also, you are placing a plastic on the slippery base, which you are expecting that it is going to function like your and do the functions of the natural teeth. Complete denture patients are often apprehensive, or they have a fear of embarrassment, like the denture being coming out in the public when they are speaking or attending any function. So you have to address that, give a proper idea about the prognosis of the treatment, give different treatment options, and accordingly let the patient decide what type of treatment he or she wants to take. And another psychological factor is gagging. So definitely you may encounter in a clinical practice, like you may have a very severe gagger, gagging patient, some patients which cannot tolerate the sight of removable dentures. So in those cases, you should suggest implant processes or kind of a fixed treatment which the patient can avoid, where the patient can avoid removable processes. Next type of factors for retention are the surgical factors. Now, under this, you have implant dentures. Often, you may have encounter patients in clinical practice who have very highly resorbed ridges. So, in those cases, in order to improve retention of the processes, we suggest for implants. Now, you can have implant-supported overdentures or even implant-supported fixed processes, depending on what is the bone quality, the bone quantity which the patient is having, and according to that, and of course economic reasons, according to that you can decide what would be the best treatment for that particular patient. So definitely if we have an implant supported processes, they increase the retention of complete dentures tremendously, and this type of treatment should be encouraged in patients who have highly resorbed ridges, or where you feel that the retention of the processes will not be that adequate in order to carry out different functions. Next type of surgical factors can be ridge extension, like vestibuloplasty, where you are increasing the space in the vestibule, and that will help in improving the retention by increasing the surface area. So we'll be discussing more about vestibuloplasty when we talk about preprosthetic surgery. So as of now, these are all the factors which I have just discussed, which will be affecting the retention of complete dentures. So with this, we come to end of our presentation. Thank you for watching the video.